How to use the frame tool in Photoshop. Find your frame tool in your toolbar. It is a rectangle with a cross. The location depends whether you've customized your toolbar. You may find it via the Edit toolbar. With the frame tool selected, go to the top left of Photoshop. You will see a rectangle and ellipse frame. Add both types of frames, so you can now see the rectangle as well as the ellipse. Click on one of the frames and then you'll see the bounding box. You can then resize as well as move the frame. Initially, I'm going to be working with the rectangle frame. So I'm going to delete the ellipse. Press the delete key. With the rectangle frame selected, go to the file menu and place embedded to add a photo. Browse for an image. As long as the frame is selected, the photo will be added to the frame. You can now resize and move the content. Click the edge of the frame to select the frame. You can go back and forth between the content and the frame. Click on the content to select it. Sometimes the click will fail. Just double click instead. Click on the edge. Make the frame a little smaller. The content is unchanged. Click on the content and then resize the content. The frame is untouched. You can repeat this over and over. To duplicate the frame, hold down the Alt Option key and then just drag. The frame and the content are duplicated. You can then resize or position the frames. You can now create thin, wide, large frames. You can create all kinds of compositions with those frames. Repeat until you're happy with your layout. You don't need to keep the same content. You can overwrite the current content with new photos from different sources. Sources can be files, layers, and libraries. Tomatoes. Go to the Libraries panel. I store many images there. Window menu and Libraries. With the frame selected, drag an image from the library to the frame. You can resize and rotate the library content. Select the frame and reposition it as you wish. Select the frame tool and then go to the top left and select the elliptical frame. Draw a new frame, this time a circle. Click the artboard to deselect the frame. Because I don't want the frame to be selected, go to File menu and Place and select a file to import. Drag the file onto the frame. It should be then added into the frame. That approach works most times. You can then resize, rotate and move the content. You can also continue to move the frame and resize the frame as well. The image was created in Affinity Photo using the procedural texture filter, a super duper filter. You can also manipulate the frame via the Properties panel. If you can't see that, go to Window and Properties. You can resize it, move it via the properties. You can also find stroke on the properties panel. What you can do, you can set a stroke width. You can also set a stroke color or give it a gradient or a colorful pattern. The stroke can be set inside the frame, around the edge of the frame, or outside of the frame. You now have a beautiful circular colored gradient edged frame. To extend this further, you can also turn it into a smart object. Go to Layers menu and Smart Objects and Convert to Smart Object. With the object selected, hold down the Alt or Option key and drag to duplicate it. Go to Layer menu, Layer Style and Bevel. Change Depth, etc. and select Drop Shadow. Change as you wish, or any other effects. Click OK. The frame has got a bevel as well as a shadow. With the smart object selected, you can also go to the filter menu and add effects such as oil paint. set cleanliness and stylization high, click OK, repeat a few times. As a smart object, you can also go to Image Menu, Adjustments, and Color Lookup and recolor the frame. Select one of the LUT presets and then click OK. Blue tone for a blue frame. Go to the Layers panel, to the smart object, and click on that little smart object icon to edit the frame. Inside the opened PSB file, you can change the frame, you can change a gradient, change the content, etc. Close the document, save the changes, you will then see the update to the frame. You can then continue to work with that frame smart object, perhaps add additional effects to it, modify it, move it, and much more. Or delete it, because now I want to work with other smart objects, in particular with custom shapes and type. Delete all the frames. Go to the toolbar, select the frame tool, go to the top left and select the elliptical frame. Draw the circular frame. Go to the custom shape tool, custom shape panel, select a custom shape and draw a shape layer. You can't drag the shape into the frame. Go to layer menu and layer style, create a bevel, click OK, go to layer menu, smart objects and convert to smart object. You can now drag the custom shape into the circular frame. Now, as frame content, you can do all the same things as before. Resize it, rotate it, etc., as well as move the frame around. Delete the custom shape frame. Go to the frame tool. Go to the top left and select elliptical frame again. Draw that frame. I want to add some type to a frame. So now go to the Type tool, set Typeface, set the font size, and then click the artboard to create the type. Drag the lorem, or whatever type you've created, to the frame. It doesn't work. It's not because it doesn't like lorem. It won't work with any type. The workaround, smart objects. Strangely enough, layer menu, smart objects, and convert to smart object. Drag the type to the frame. The type becomes content for the frame. You can then resize, rotate, etc. You can also then go and change the type. It's just a standard smart object. You can go to the properties panel and change the stroke for the frame. Change the stroke width. Change the frame edge to a gradient or pattern. Perhaps also including type within the pattern. The frame tool can be used in countless ways. You can use it for compositional layouts, etc., but you can also use it for wonderful designs for quick and easy masking. Hope you found this tutorial of interest. Always adding new tutorials about Photoshop as well as other applications, so please subscribe to the Graphicxtras channel. Also, some comments, always appreciated. A dislike or like. Thank you much.